So right now, there are a lot of people out there and they are trying to decide what to do with their old laptops.
A perfect storm of getting new gadgets during the Christmas holidays combined with a 1-2 punch of spring cleaning while binge-watching Marie Kondo, there is a good chance that you are cleaning out your drawers and shelves and doing this.
I remember you. I forgot you were on Windows Vista.
So a very easy and free way to make an old laptop run like new again is to install Google's Chrome operating system on it. Visit neverwhere.com and follow the easy-to-use instructions. All you need is an 8GB memory stick.
It actually took 2 minutes just to boot Windows Vista. It only took 45 seconds to boot into Google Chrome OS. That alone made the laptop feel new, and it was absolutely free.
So I don't really subscribe to the belief of having a secondary laptop for the kitchen or couch surfing, because new computers have never been smaller, more portable, or have better battery life. Chances are, if you've got a new computer, you don't really have a use case for your old one, but you do have options.
Firstly, you can donate it. There are always non-profits and schools looking for extra computers, anything from a special needs school to a crisis centre. If we determine the computer has future potential, we can always give it to a family member or relative who needs a new laptop. Or lastly, sell the laptop for cash to line your pocket, which surely got burnt during the Christmas holidays.
So Apple laptops are a great candidate to upgrade. And in this case, my mum got a new MacBook, which meant we had to decide what to do with this. So after transferring her files over, I wiped the drive and I researched what operating system I could install on the laptop.
With this nearly 10 years old MacBook Pro, while I was able to upgrade it from OS X Line to El Capitan, I actually managed to get Mojave working on it with a patch. Since otherwise the laptop was in great shape besides a missing key, I decided to upgrade it. 65 euro buys me a replacement key, a 120GB solid state drive and 8GB of RAM. Following iFixit's instructions, I disconnected the battery before upgrading the hard drive and memory. If you're planning to perform upgrades on a similar MacBook for someone or even yourself to use for the next couple of years, consider buying a new battery as well, and they cost about 35 euro. I patched a USB key with Mojave following the instructions on this website, and the install was actually seamless. I did encounter one error, but I was actually able to fix it by changing the date and terminal before performing the install.
The result is a fully functioning, up-to-date Apple laptop. It's great for things like web browsing and email and Netflix and Spotify, basically anything a college student would do. However, it's still 10 years old, so it's no longer a pro computer, but it's still a solid laptop. However, everyone in my family has an up-to-date computer, so I'm going to sell this.
I actually sold the MacBook for 350 euro minus the 65 euro in upgrades, and I made 285 euro. Not bad for something that most people would just throw out.
I will say that I don't believe upgrading the Mac will dramatically improve any profit margin, but I definitely believe it will improve the likelihood of you making a sale, because who wants to buy a computer they don't have to put work into fixing? What about an old Windows laptop? I also found a Sony Vaio in our attic, and this came with Microsoft Windows Vista Home Premium. Now, PC laptops come from all different brands and shapes and sizes, so I wouldn't really recommend upgrading, especially to sell any laptop that is running Windows XP, as that tends to denote that your laptop was manufactured before 2007. If the laptop does appear to be very old, try Chrome's operating system I mentioned earlier to see if that provides any performance benefit. Like the MacBook Pro, I purchased a hard drive, more memory, and an OEM license of Windows 10 to upgrade the Sony Vaio laptop, and that came to about 46.25 euro. Now, with a lot of Windows laptops, there will not actually be instructions on the internet on how to upgrade it, unless you get very lucky with a YouTube video. But a lot of older PC laptops have these memory doors that allow easy access to upgrade the RAM. Before buying new parts, disassemble the old laptop, and since it's an old laptop, you don't mind if you break it anyway. But you need to make sure you're able to perform the upgrades and the laptop isn't too tricky to open before buying parts you cannot use. You also need to do this to make sure you're buying the correct memory and hard drive upgrades for that laptop model.
To install Windows 10, you can get it directly from the Microsoft website with a free media creation tool. All you need is an 8GB memory stick. You don't need to buy a Windows 10 license straight away, so you can demo out the new version of Windows to see how it runs on the laptop. You might decide that Chrome is still the superior operating system for this upgrade.
The result? A fully functioning, up-to-date Windows laptop. Like the MacBook, it's great for web browsing and YouTube, but it is a bit slower because it only tops out at 4GB of memory and it has a slower Pentium processor. As long as you don't have too many websites open at the same time, you're good to go. If you plan to keep the laptop, I'd consider using Google Chrome. First off, you won't have to buy a Windows 10 license. But secondly, Chrome is faster, it only turns on in a few seconds. And what we're seeing now is peak performance of the laptop. Any individual would then have to install antivirus software and other utilities that will slow the laptop down. If you plan just to use the laptop for web browsing and Google Docs and even Microsoft Office Online, use Chrome. But if you do plan to sell the laptop, Windows 10 is a much easier sell. So, that's just a few ways you can make an old laptop run like new and what you can do with an old laptop you have lying around on a shelf or cupboard. But now I'd like to hear from you. I'd love to hear what you've been doing with that old laptop you've had lying around. Leave a comment below so I can read it, and if I get many comments, I might even do a follow-up video where we do like a viewer's suggestion episode. I think that could be really cool, but I think I need comments for that. Also leave a comment if you followed my ideas and you brought an old laptop back to life. I'd love to hear what you're doing with it. Thanks for watching and subscribe to see more videos right now. Leave a comment if you followed my ideas and you brought an old laptop